Hey, and welcome to my channel here at Mia Danielle, where I share all about holistic, clutter-free spaces. If you're into that, then go ahead and click subscribe and turn on notifications because I release new videos every Tuesday. So, of course, a big part of creating and maintaining a holistic, clutter-free environment has to do with what you're purchasing. You know, what types of things are you bringing into your space and what types of things are becoming a part of your space in the process. So I thought that it would be fun if I shared 15 of my best purchases from 2020. If you see something that you like, I have all of the links that are down in the description. So go ahead and click a thumbs up and let's dive in. When I first started thinking about this idea of the best purchases or my favorite purchases from 2020, the very first thing that came to my mind, and I was immediately excited about this, was actually Charlie's dog bowl. So some of you who have been around the channel for a while are familiar with Charlie. She's made some cameos in some of my videos. She is just over 2 years old. So the reason that this dog bowl is such a big thing is because for the first year and a half of us having Charlie, we battled with trying to find the right dog bowl for her because she is such a sloppy drinker. Every time she would drink, water would just go everywhere. There would be puddles all over the wood floor. She would walk away from the water bowl and would just be like pouring out of both sides of her mouth as she walked and left a trail of water. And we tried so many different kinds. We went to PetSmart, we went to Amazon, all these different places and tried different styles. We had the side-by-side puppy dog food and water bowl. We had like the big stainless steel ones that had a really firm foundation. We have put rugs or little mats underneath her water bowl. We've surrounded it with towels. It's been an issue, but we bought this miraculous water bowl. I don't even know what you would call it, on Amazon that has completely eliminated any water drippage. I seriously think that this is the most genius thing. I can't believe that they don't have it at every local store, but basically it just has this giant plastic piece that floats on top of the water inside of this bowl. And the bowl holds a good amount of water, so you're not having to fill it too frequently. We fill ours maybe once a day, once every other day, and it just floats on top of the water. And somehow the pressure of her tongue pushes it down just enough to get the amount of water that she needs to be able to drink and no excess. So we're not sloshing water around anymore. We don't even have to surround it by mats or towels. Anybody with cats or dogs who has an issue with there being water leaking or drippage around the water bowl, this has been advertised as being great for either or. The second best purchase I made in 2020 is definitely this Sigma lens that I'm recording from right now. You can definitely tell a big difference from before I made the switch to after I made the switch with this lens. It's just such a difference. So if anybody is into YouTubing or just recording their own videos professionally, it was totally worth the purchase. I tried to lowball and look at other options. I even tried another lens that was on the lower end. And let me just say, this is definitely the way to go. This is a Sigma 30mm 1.4 f-stop lens. And it has a really nice creamy blur of the background. I heard about it a lot on different YouTube channels, so I knew that it was a really good lens, but it has not disappointed. My number three best purchase for 2020 would have to be the bedside lamps that we got. If you watched my video on decluttering the bedroom, then you saw me go through the process of installing and measuring these. I did install them myself. They don't have to be hardwired in, although they do have the option to do that if you prefer. But the ones that I'm using are just plugged into the wall behind each of the nightstands. And what I like about this is that before we were using table lamps. So it was taking up space on our table. Our tables were looking a little bit crowded. And also we had two different size lamps, so it just made the room look kind of off. And this, I really love the ambiance. I love the way they have their own dimmer switch, so I can set it to as dim as I want to be able to read a book while Matt goes to sleep. We have them both set to go off with the Alexas so that we can turn each one on and off by our voice. They can be repositioned really easily, but probably my favorite thing is just that it's not taking up any more space on the nightstand, and it has a very nice symmetrical look to it. My fourth favorite purchase from 2020 would definitely have to be our Eero system. That's E-E-R-O. This is like a Wi-Fi extending network from Amazon. So before we had our router and our modem, and we were constantly, I feel like, changing out the router because it was never picking up as well as we had hoped. And in fact, we have three different stories to our condo here. So we couldn't get Wi-Fi at all down on the first story, which is now where my office is as part of the garage. And we also couldn't get any Wi-Fi in the dining room and the bathroom that's off on that side on the second floor because the router was up on the top floor in our bedroom. So we got this Eero system after trying many different extender options and Wi-Fi connectors. We tried all these different things, and I have no idea why we didn't hear about this sooner, but it comes with three different Wi-Fi extender boxes called Eeros. They're small and white. They look nice, just like the Amazon Alexa Dots, etc. And we keep them in three different spaces in our home. So we have one in our bedroom, we have one in the kitchen, and we have one in the living room, which kind of makes a triangular effect at our home. So it's able to pick up Wi-Fi everywhere. And we have not had any Wi-Fi issues since making that change. It's really incredible. I wish we had gone with this like a year earlier. Not only that, but like I mentioned in my last video, we now have access to control what devices, what people, what profiles are able to access the Wi-Fi. So for example, if we want to shut off everything for one of my daughters, like her TV, her computer, her iPhone, it's all under her profile. All we have to do is click a button and all of her Wi-Fi goes away. If we want our kids to go to bed and get off their phones at 10 o'clock when they're supposed to be starting to go to sleep, then we can just go and turn off both of their phones. So now we have total control over what is able to access our Wi-Fi and at what times, and it's really been convenient. My number five favorite purchase would have to be these I Love earbuds. They're wireless earbuds. You can charge them with the regular micro USB charger, and they work really well. You can tap them to pause or to, you know, unpause, and they just fit really nicely inside of your ear. So here, I'll try one on for you so you can see how tiny they are. They just fit great and they stay in there, which is amazing. I never would have thought that they would stay in as well as they do. I wear these things while I exercise. I wear them while I do yoga and I'm in downward dog and they don't fall out. We actually like them so much that we ended up getting another pair for my youngest daughter. So she has her own that are black. And then just last week, we ended up getting another pair for Matt. We went with a different color this time so that we wouldn't get them all mixed up. But we are just starting to collect these things like candy around here. And they fit just really easily inside of your pocket or your purse. So I definitely recommend these. Now, I've mentioned rosehip seed oil a lot. I mentioned it in my video on things that I just own one of because it takes the place of so many different items like moisturizers. You can use this thing on your hair, on your skin. I lather my face with it every single day. It's like one of the only things that makes my face feel just completely not parched because I feel like my skin gets dry so easily. So this is Rada, I think. Rada or Rada. I don't know how you say it, but their rosehip seed oil, it does have a little bit of a yellow color to it. That's just the natural color of rosehip seed oil, but it works really well and it's really good for you. And a lot of people have sworn by this for, you know, keeping away wrinkles because it's really high in antioxidants, etc. So I gotta give this a shout out because I use it so frequently. It's like my number one self-care product. Speaking of self-care product, I switched over to these wet dry brushes at some point in 2020. I've had this one, I feel like, for quite some time. In fact, when I was looking it up, I just went ahead and ordered another one. But this thing has held up really well. I worried about the bristles on it, like becoming smashed and leaning off to one side or another. But because this has these little massage nodule things in it, it really doesn't do that. It really helps to keep the bristles straight. Also, I was worried that the nodules in it would be uncomfortable when I was scrubbing myself down because I use this in place of a loofah. This is the thing that I use to scrub my body off. And they don't bother me at all. Like, you hardly even notice. If anything, I would say they add to it because it actually feels pretty nice, especially on your feet. So I really do enjoy these things. I'm going to keep going with them instead of wasting money. I feel like the little plastic loofahs, not only are they bad for the environment, but they get gross and they get loose so quickly. I definitely recommend these things. There are a lot of health benefits that have come out for the wet dry brushes. You'll have to look it up. If you've ever heard of dry brushing, it's become really popular here lately because it helps to increase the circulation and it helps to remove, of course, dead skin cells. So take a look at that because I don't know. I've seen a lot about them, but I just really like the way it feels. And I like the way that it scrubs up the bubbles really well. And I feel completely exfoliated every time I get out of the bath. Now, while we're on the bathroom train, I do have one other thing that I've been using for over a year now, but I found this pack of muslin cloths for $12 on Amazon, and you get a pack of 20 of them. But they're so small and thin, and at the same time, again, just rough enough to give you a nice, good exfoliation. I like these so much better than the terry cloth face cloths, because the terry cloth ones I feel like are really plush and they hold in a bunch of oils and facial products and whatever it is you're using to wash your face. But these, they take up like hardly any space inside of your wash load, and they don't absorb and hold on to all of the facial products that you use to wash your face off with. Number 9 would have to be my Ajna yoga mat. I really like all of their stuff. I've followed them on Instagram because their supplies are so pretty. And I got this because it looked like a piece of art almost. They had some very artistic ones, but it matches my floor. So at the time I was doing a whole lot of yoga in the dining room. This was right after COVID started. And sometimes I would leave my mat there and then come back to it later. And I wanted something that didn't look really tacky laying there on the floor. And this actually looked like an intentional mat that was placed on the floor. So it also has just this really nice grippage to it with the bumps or dots that they have on here. And it's held up really well. It has just the right amount of pressure for me underneath without being too cushiony to where I feel like I'm sinking into it. Now, after last summer, after killing so many plants because I've always had such a black thumb, I decided that I was just gonna go fake. Artificial succulents, artificial plants, all the way. I'm probably still going to try to meander and mingle with different types of plants during the spring and summertime, but for inside the house, I've decided to go with some artificial plants. And I've set these up in the dining room and on some of the shelves that we have and in the bathrooms. And I just really like the way that they look. And I like that I don't have to stress out about whether or not I'm going to kill them. And honestly, I was able to get a really good price for them. I bought them as one big bundle that came with just tons of different little succulents in it. So I feel like that was definitely a worthy purchase, as it has now become one of my core decor components. Speaking of shelves that hold my succulents, I did get this 3-part mini shelf to go in our dining room. We had no decor on any of our walls in there, and we just had one blank table. And I felt like it could just use something a little bit extra, just something to kind of draw the eyes up or add some level of interest to that space. So we found these 3 little shelves. They fit perfectly in the space. We just decorate them with some of the little ceramics that the girls have made over the years. And of course, some of these artificial succulents that we purchased. Something that I was really excited to be able to find last year that actually worked out really well is this half umbrella for the deck. So we had tried the cheap umbrellas. We had tried the ones that you can get at Rite Aid or Walgreens, and we had tried the round umbrellas. The thing is, our deck is really small. It's a tiny deck, and it's kind of like narrow and longer than it is wide. And so trying to find something that would work there, I had no clue that these half umbrellas even existed, but we ordered one. It came in and I love it. It has held up to the rainy weather here in Portland and the wind that we get during the winter times here in Portland. The color hasn't faded, but mostly it just fits on the deck, which is awesome. I'm able to put a little table and chairs around it and still have room to move around. So definitely a fan of the half umbrella. I think that was a totally worthy and valid purchase that I would 100% make again. I grew up in Southeast Texas, so fried foods are like a part of my heritage, and we try not to do it very often. In fact, we have an air fryer now, so we're hardly ever frying, but when we do fry or make burger patties or make bacon, finding what to do with that grease was a hassle. And we used to try to like balance pour it into like a large container of some sort. But it would still like drain around the container and still get into the sink. So I found this little funnel, and we can use it with any 2-liter or any bottle and just pour it in, and has made this whole process so much easier. And so I would definitely say, for convenience sake and for not wanting to destroy your plumbing in your sink, having one of these little metal funnels that also happens to sift out any pieces that fall into it has been really cool, something that we've definitely used. And the final two best purchases for me for 2020 are this Apple USB converter, because it not only allows me to plug things that require a USB port into it, which any of you who have a MacBook Air or MacBook Pro know that it can be a pain in the butt trying to find things that actually fit into one of the very few ports that you have available on this machine. I love the machine, but it does not have enough ports for what you need to use. So I got this so that I can attach USBs to it, but also I can put my memory card from my camera directly in here and upload all of my videos and my photos for these YouTube videos. So this is something that I used just about on a daily basis. And finally, last but not least, something that I use every day or at least every time I'm in my car, and it's my favorite accessory that did not come with the car itself, is my cell phone holder. It is a mounted cell phone holder that has these squeezable sides so you can adjust it to whatever size you need, and you can turn it and twist it to look in any direction that you want. And then just with like the push of a button, it opens up and releases. This has been awesome. I've tried so many different cell phone holders. It's great to be able to have my phone right there to use as a GPS when I'm driving around, which is the main reason that I use it. And also I have my Bluetooth set up to the Mini to be able to answer phone calls via the Bluetooth speakers. So it's just great to be able to have it right there in whatever position I need it in. And especially in my Mini, vent holders will not work. And so many cell phone holders out there require to use your vents. And also that can kind of mess up the vents because it drags them down. But this one fits into the CD player, which is great because I never use my CD player. Like, who really listens to CDs anymore now that you can stream things from your phone, which is what I do. So this has been a really great investment. I would recommend this to anybody. So those are my 15 top purchases from 2020. Let me know what some of yours are. Are there things that come to your mind that you're like, oh, I've been dying to tell somebody about this. I bought it last year and it is just the best. I would buy it a million times over. I would love to hear those down below. If you like this video, then you'll probably like this other video that I have called Things That I Only Own One Of. And you might even notice there are a few things that made both of these lists. So go check that one out and I will catch you next week.